Wonderful good day, ladies and gentlemen. We are still at the Dolder Grand Hotel at the event of Zurich Invest. And with me here is now Stephen Alfers, the CEO of Pershing Gold out of Nevada. You know, the emerging gold producer. Hopefully they go soon into production. And the good thing is we were speaking here at the PDIC, of course, but also we were speaking here last year exactly at the same time. And now we want to talk, if he has delivered what he has promised.
Stephen. Well, Johan, thank you for having me with you here today. And it was just 1 year ago that we were right here talking about what 2015 was going to look like for Pershing Gold.
Yeah, so you had told us a lot of good things you want to do, like you wanted to list it in New York, you wanted to clean up your share structure, all those nice little things. You wanted to do like a preliminary economic assessment, an internal one, I have to say. So elaborate a bit. What have you delivered?
Well, over the past year, we did in fact list on NASDAQ, a major exchange in New York. Mm-hmm. We had continued with the completion of a major drilling program around the mine itself at the Relief Canyon mine. We continued to work on our engineering and metallurgical work there. Mm-hmm. We did an internal economic assessment that allowed us to see what the economics would look like and establish what our cost structure would be. And the cost structure is very favorable.
Can you elaborate a bit what the cost structure is?
We were in the range of all-in sustaining costs around $725 to $745. Mm-hmm. And I can say with continued drilling and continued work, and in the next month or so, we'll see the PEA. I'm expecting to see those costs continue to drop. For the rest of 2016, for your audience and our investors, they can watch for that preliminary economic assessment. Mm-hmm. On the back of that PEA, what I'd expect to see is immediately launch into our effort for a pre-feasibility study. Mm-hmm. We'll complete that feasibility study this year. And ahead of that, we'll do additional engineering work, geotechnical work, mm-hmm. in order to provide that last bit of data we need for that pre-feasibility study.
Mm-hmm. Fantastic. So that sounds to me that you are really on the fast track for a production decision. I mean, gold is rising, silver is rising. Certainly a environment which we hoped for, but what we did not expect or for the first quarter or the second quarter here in this year, but we hope for it. When can we maybe expect the decision process to start?
We'll see a decision on the completion of that pre-feasibility study. Mm-hmm. I'd expect to see that in Q4 of this year. And let's face it, right now we can see that for the first time in many years, we have the wind at our back. Mm-hmm. Because we have rising gold prices. Yeah. Above the kinds of numbers most of us need in this industry to really mm-hmm. thrive. So things are looking really good. Be alert. We'll make a decision on the timing of a startup of the mine, and mm-hmm. we'll do that toward the end of Q4.
Great. I mean, there's no doubt you are in a fantastic jurisdiction. I mean, Nevada is one of the most sensational mining places in the world, that's for sure. You did everything right so far. You are fully permitted. You have the expansion permit also. That all worked out. I think environmentally, you are also in good shape, as far as I know. You have a processing facility. You are at the Relief Canyon mine. But what do you need money-wise? What is your expectation to really restart in production?
Well, we have, through a financing that we achieved just a couple of months ago, we have $14 million or more in the bank right now, mm-hmm. Against a running rate of $500,000 a month. So we have a good runway to make our decisions here. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Once we make a decision to start the mine, we'll take a look at the timing of that decision and what it means for us for sustaining capital. Look around, and it'll be a small number. We may have to go out and raise some mm-hmm. at some point. Something in the $5-10 million range.
Well, that's
for
not
the
that
purposes
much.
Just sustaining us all the way to positive cash flow. So it'll mm-hmm. be those sorts of granular kinds of decisions that we'll make this year.
Fantastic.
Easy for us to make.
Yeah, absolutely. Now I would say that too. And when can we expect maybe a resource update?
The resource update is nearly complete. It will be part of the PEA that we'll see released, we hope, in May. Not much after that, maybe May to June.
Wow, that's fast. So that's pretty fast.
It's a compressed timeline for us now. Things that we've been promising for some time are coming to roost right now. Mm-hmm.
Great. Last question. I know the data is not yet ready, but I want you to, let's say, speculate a little bit. What would you expect would be the run rate per annum?
Oh, I'd expect us to ramp up life of mine to something mm-hmm. like 5 million tons a year, mm-hmm. With the opportunity to produce gold at 80 to 100,000 ounces a year.
Oh, wow.
For life of this mine of 5-6 years so mm-hmm. far. And remember, this is a project that is not complete. It's not mm-hmm. yet drilled out. Mm-hmm. So the opportunity is there to continue to grow this deposit mm-hmm. as we, in fact, mine it.
Fantastic. Stephen, thank you very much for that.
Thank you.
We keep fingers crossed, and we want to see very soon good results.
Well, thank you, and thank all of you for your attention to Pershing Gold.
Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, it was Stephen Ivers, the CEO of Pershing Gold. Well, you heard it. 80 to 100,000 ounces are possible in the production. The company is well cashed up, and maybe they need another 5 to 10 million to really go then into production once the decision is made. Everything is full on track, so we can expect about the next 9 months the decision, definitely. And yeah, the guys do a great job. Check out the company. Thanks, and bye-bye from Zurich.